the Lakers are slowing it up here, and they have to make up 17 points, and they've got to get that ball down and get quick points.
They're looking for Jerry West. Howell switches off on West.
Rebound.
And Jerry West. Of course, a most valuable player award will be given here tonight for the man most valuable during the entire seven games, and Jerry West has won it.
And a pass break to Walt Frazier. Frazier then slows it down, is picked up by Jerry West at the top of the post. Reed scores! Willis Reed scores the first bucket here tonight in New York lead.
He can try Willis Reed.
And Reed now is outside. There's his second shot. He is 2 for 2. Willis Reed.
Willis Reed, named the most valuable player in the just-concluded NBA Championship Series with the Knicks down number one.
You never know. I mean, with the great team, with Al Cinder and all other great ball players and teams in this league, you don't know what will happen next year. Why wait to say, we'll do it next year. Let's do it this year, and we've done it. And this is the greatest feeling I've had since I've been playing basketball.
That was a tough shot by Marin. He just tried to get it up there. There you are again. 7'5", no doubt.
He's got the rebound after the missed shot.
That is the round.
But the Bucks are disorganized to some extent out there without Robertson in that backcourt. They rely on him so much, and when he's out of there, they're running around. They're not as organized as they normally would be.
Picks him up into Unsold. Blocked by guess who? Al Cinder. Oh, 24 points.
Lou, congratulations. Oscar just paid you a great compliment. You had a great series. Congratulations.
It was a big help.
He was a big help.
This is not to play the hell of a game.
How about yourself? You played a great game. Congratulations on the MVP.
Thank you very much.
So the Lakers get it. They go to Wilt with it. He's going to the basket. And he did it with a right hand, and it had to hurt.
Monroe. Put it up again. Chamberlain flaps it out.
Chamberlain on a great pass by West.
Back fill it again. That's four steals for Jimmy. Go to Chamberlain. He's under the bucket.
Stops on four. And they run it out. And the Los Angeles Lakers have won their first NBA title ever. Reed's wide open. Bridges comes too late. Knicks are hugging each other and having some fun, but they inbound it, the clock goes, and the game is over, and New York has won the ball game.
Here goes Westfall. His jump shot is held up, and he gets to White. Now Havlicek pops. And hit. He's fouled. And it counts. Havlicek is loose. His shot is tough, but good. The second clock is on your screen. Havlicek. Tough move there, and it counts.
Boy, that basket right there is so important for the Celtics. John Havlicek making a great move. Here he comes off of the screens being set. Fakes Kareem in the air. Goes by him right down the middle.
John Havlicek at the line.
Havlicek.
Foul by McLaughlin.
Dick Garrett, 2 seconds, 1 second. He's all over. The Boston Celtics are the champions of the NBA for the 12th time.
Rick Barry. Reardon with a hand on him. Barry wants it. Here comes Unsell. He loses it. Dickey quickly. Barry's got to get it. Johnson holds it high. Comes across to Rick Barry and pops. That's 18 points for Barry so far.
That Big E kept that ball alive, brother.
Here's Rick Barry, left side, gets up, right-handed jump hook.
Wow, hey, that's a great move.
And clock begins to run out. Chenier goes inside, in the air, not there. There, could be all over, hold on.
I think it is going to be all over now. I think that's going to do it.
That should do it. Sliding inside for the trophy presentation in just a moment.
It's everything. It's everything. It's the only goal I've ever set in my life was pro basketball. That's everything. My only wish I was in a position to retire now because this is done.
Silas back to White. Gar Hurd right with him, and White came up inside.
How did he get control on that shot?
I tell you what, he shot that with his left hand, an underhand, one-hand scoop shot with the left hand flying through the air.
JoJo White, 79-71.
Dennis Autry will take Towns right now, trying to cut off the passing lane. White with control, came back up with a shot. Celtics up 56-54. It is all over. It has come to an end, and the Boston Celtics have won their 13th NBA championship.
JoJo White, on behalf of the CBS crew, your award, a gold watch for the most valuable player in the championship series. Congratulations to you.
Thanks a lot, Mindy. I really wish it was 12 watches in here. Everybody stuck together, and they pulled when we were down a couple of times, and we fought back, and I'm just happy that we were able to win it again.
On the switch, it's Gross with him. Here's Mixon battling inside. Walton came over to the top for the defensive block. It's approximately left first half. High. Irving. Walton challenges. Walton. Went to Gross on the pass, even though Irving was there. And Walton took it back with the jump hook. Here's McGinnis. Lucas comes out. McGinnis for the tie. It's off. Irving is there.
Has hurt the Sonics, allowing that penetration by the opposition's guards.
Knocked away by Unseld. Unseld gives it right back, and Dandridge wants to go inside. It's a six-point lead as Unseld hits the field goal. Washington leading Seattle in the seventh and decisive game. Second period, Kupchak lost it right back to Unseld, who drills one outside. Unseld gets free of Webster. Back to eight.
And I'm very happy to be here with Jerry Sachs, Bob Ferry, our coach Dick Motta, and Wes Unseld, who has been waiting a while for all of this. I want to tell you that tonight, the Washington Bullets have reached the peak of world basketball.
Unford tapped it off to JJ, and here comes Dennis. In a foot race with Charles, inside the glass. Pretty play by Dennis Johnson that time. Turn on, Sikma misses. Loose, run down by Dennis Johnson. On the dribble, he got past right. Henrich comes with him. Dennis comes in with a field goal, and he's fouled. Score it for DJ Dennis Johnson out of Pepperdine.
Here's Dennis Johnson. What a great crossover dribble. He just has Larry Wright falling down. Bobby D chasing him. He sees it's a hopeless situation. When he bent over there, he made contact. That's the foul.
Right at the start of it, as you look at it again from another angle, good move by DJ, protecting the ball well.
Ballard assigned to him. Inside backdoor to Dennis. Turns on Dandridge and puts down two more. Dennis Johnson has played an unbelievable series. 16 points now for DJ.
Seattle Supersonics capture the NBA championship by dethroning the Washington Bullets in five games to become the world's number one basketball team.
On the interception, on the lazy pass, it is that rookie again. Magic dishes Wilkes this time. Nine on the shot clock. Whip it inside to Magic. 38 points. It's Doctor's ball. Stolen by Nixon on the bad pass. Norman comes back, and here's Magic inside for the layup. Run is still alive as Jones yanks it away. Quickly now to Johnson. Bibby gambled. Magic comes inside. Dishes wants Wilkes. Beautiful pass. And now it is a 14-point run.
20 years old and won a state championship in high school, an NCAA championship, and now a world championship.
Very little left to conquer.
And here's the man of the hour, Magic Johnson. Magic, what do you have that makes you perform like this in these championship games?
Well, I don't know. Just I love to win, and I guess that's the thing. I go in thinking we can win any game that I play, despite, you know, Kareem wasn't in, and we want to say, hey, we did it for you, big fella, because you got us here, and we don't want to take nothing away from him.
Closer for the shot or take the three-pointer. Don't just stand there in no man's land.
Cedric Maxwell, beautiful play on his part. Harris Ford, nice pass to Maxwell. And Cedric Maxwell now with 13 points. A win here, the Celtics with their 14th NBA World Championship play. If not, it's Game 7 Sunday. Fred Maxwell, you see 2 seconds, one, and the world champion, the Boston Celtics.
How does it feel to have been able to accomplish that?
Rick, it's a tremendous feeling. You know how it is when you win the world championship. And by all means, everybody's standing up just cheering. I'm just lost for words. It's just a tremendous feeling.
Listen, enjoy
Thank
it.
You. All right.
Tighten it.
Hey, Mom! Hey, Mom! I'm home!
All right.
Middleman Magic. Magic underneath to Rambo. Score 6-0.
12-6 is the score, and Magic's going to take the ball. He's going to be the choreographer. He's across the orange 10-second line. He's going left to right across your dial. He takes it under to Rambus. He's there. He slam dunks it. He slam dunks it, and down goes Dawkins. Bobby McAdoo. McAdoo to midcourt to Magic Johnson. Magic coming to the right side of the pass to Cooper. Score! Brooks dribbles around Irving. Whips the ball to McAdoo. McAdoo's 10-foot jumper on the way. No. Rebound in Magic Johnson.
McAdoo finally missed one, and Magic right there.
To Magic Johnson. 9-point lead. 2 minutes gone by.
3-2-1. The Lakers are the world champions.
It's great. Come here, boy. Yeah, finally got one.
Magic, right, congratulations. Right. Tell me what Bob McAdoo has meant to this team.
I tell you, an offensive weapon coming off the bench.
Mac Rito.
A big man who can do it all, run the court, block shots too.
Charlito.
He's just a big weapon. I tell you, I'm just glad that we had him on our team.
This is the time for the Lakers to be careful. In the last two games, they had good leads midway through the second period, but the Sixers closed the gap and came on strong. One early and one late. Moses Malone drives in.
There it goes. Cheeks on his way to the world championship to Moses. Slam dunk. The game is over, and so is the World Championship Series. The Sixers rout the Lakers 115-108.
Harris out to Maxwell. It's a 3-on-2 break for Boston. And Larry Bird has his second basket. Setting something up with Larry Bird, who gets it low. Puts a move on Byron Scott. What a move by Larry Bird. Here's Magic off the mark. Lakers had several chances, and here's Larry Bird chucking down the court.
Well, they hung in there very well without Kurt Rambis in the first half.
Bird. How does he do it?
I don't know.
Larry Bird, congratulations. You were the most valuable player. And I must add that they said you were going to be the MVP if Boston even lost this game tonight. That's how great this series was. What does it mean to Larry?
Well, it means a lot, but there's a lot of players out there still capable of winning the MVP award, Bernard King and Jabbar and some of the others. But right now, we just feel happy about winning.
Don't be nasty. Inside, Kareem from Magic Johnson. And Magic says, let's settle down. He has a triple-double again. And Kareem comes back again.
That's got to be the ultimate thrill for the Lakers.
Kareem hits again with a skyhook. The Lakers are less than a minute away.
Kareem, you are the unanimous winner of the Sport Magazine Most Valuable Player. I don't think you've ever been MVP in a championship series, have you?
Yeah, I was in 1971, but everybody's forgotten that.
Kareem, congratulations.
But Peterson may have nightmares guarding Larry Bird.
What a pass to McHale. 2 seconds on the shot clock. Bird wants a three out of it, and he gets it. 1-1. McRae didn't go for the fake. Pass back. On this Super Sunday, they have a lot to cheer about. Another great Boston Celtic effort. Who knew when they lost to Portland in December that that would be the only game they would lose all year and win 50 and lose only one on the parquet floor.
It's a privilege to present the 1986 NBA Finals Most Valuable Player Award for the second time around, Larry Bird. Larry.
We came to play. And when we come to play on our home court and we're aggressive, things are going to happen.
Out. Quicking the Lakers.
Magic with a hook. Left-hand variety. Worthy keeps it going. AC Green. Half a minute to go in the first half, and Magic comes back. Both Bird and Magic have been quiet offensively, and now they may be heating up. The Celtics have gotten the hoop to give them a three-point lead, but Worthy saves it for Magic Johnson, and a brilliant play by James Worthy. You may see a lot of Cooper in this half. Magic goes in against Ainge, Lakers. Magic.
The most valuable player.
for the third time. They have won four championships, and Magic Johnson, an MVP unanimous choice. Congratulations.
Thank you. It was a total team effort, really. You know, we all just chipped in and just got the job done, and it's just great to be a champ again.
Kareem looking for someone, and Cooper finds Worthy inside, and he gets it over John Sally. That was a tough shot over Sally. Who goes strong to the hoop, gets the basket, and draws the foul. And right now we're looking at a Dantley Worthy shootout here in quarter number one. Turnover, I am surprised. All of a sudden they came out of it. Worthy going strong to the hoop over Lane Beer. He didn't want to pick up that third foul.
That's leadership, what you're seeing right now.
Worthy working his way into the hoop. Loose ball, Lakers will get it. Worthy, two Pistons are back. And the basket's going to count, goaltending. James Worthy gets credit for the basket, John Sally.
James, congratulations on being the MVP of this series.
Thank you very much, Brent. You know, this was a tough year, and we really had a lot to accomplish, but I would just like to say the reason why I was able to make it through this season is standing right here, Brent. Angela, she stayed with me the whole year, supported me, ups and downs and everything, and she's responsible, too.
Angela, tough for the wives, too.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
We go through it just like they yes! do!
Who also has very long arms. Down the middle comes Dumar. He's got it. He shoots. 8-foot jumper straight away is good, despite the fact that Campbell got a piece of the ball.
A well-played game, really, at both ends for both teams so far this half. Dumar getting hot, hits a second in a row. He's
forced him into a shot they couldn't make. Here's the ball. Dumar's at the base. 18-foot jumper. That's the ball game, I would think. 1 minute to play.
Just such a solid, gutty performance on your part. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot. We worked hard for it. That was our purpose coming into this season. From day one, we wanted to get here, and here we are.
Times blew by the defender. Off the hands of Drexler, another turnover.
Look out here.
Thomas releasing. Thomas the rebound. The lead is three for the Trailblazers with just under 4 minutes to go in the first period. Thomas all the way in. Beautiful play by Isaiah. He's got six. Thomas from the corner.
Oh,
remember the corner shot the other night that gave him the lead for good. Huh? Isaiah penetrates off the glass.
Of who gets the spot.
Jump control by Isaiah Thomas. 21 on the shot clock. Here's Thomas. Tie score at 90-90. 7/10 of a second. There's the shot. And the game's over, and the Pistons have won the world championship. Back to back.
Congratulations. Thanks, Pat. This one's sweeter than the last one.
Oh, yeah, it's much sweeter. Because we had our work cut out for us. Everybody doubted us all season long. And it was a tough road. Anytime you go back to back, we won the only three teams to ever do it in history. And this is a special team. Very special.
To fire away. He's now 1 for 9. The look away to Livingston. Jordan. Oh, a spectacular move by Michael Short. That's 13 consecutive field goals. Coming up on 2 minutes. Remaining in this first quarter, Jordan off the steal. The Lakers back to Divac, bringing it up, and he lost it. Jordan off the steal. Jordan to the reverse. So Michael able to answer. And Magic looking to push it down court. Here's Green, stripped by Jordan. Pippen with Perkins back. In the fourth, now Campbell on Jordan. Went to the fadeaway. What a move. Jordan, but the game is tied at 76.
And there's that weak side attack as Jordan takes the lob off the back pick play. Michael Jordan can sense that the crowd is in it, that the Lakers are in it. He's going to take it into his own hands.
Michael Jordan is the unanimous MVP. Michael, what does it mean to you?
It means so much. I mean, not just for me, but for the team, for the whole city. It's been a 7-year struggle. I mean, when I first got into Chicago, we started at the bottom, and
every year we just worked harder and harder until we got to it. And, you know, it's so gratifying. You know, I'm appreciated so long in my life, you know, for my family, for my kids, everything. It's the most proud day I've ever had.
Mercy play by Pippen. That's Drexler. And it's rejected by Jordan. Michael Jordan with the rejection. He had some help from Cartwright.
Well, they front the post to make the lob pass take place. The good rotation by Bill stops him from getting the layup.
Drexler playing with four. Here's Jordan. The backdoor pass picked off on the deflection. Jordan with the steal!
You told me the other night in Portland, this one would be more relief. The other one was exhilaration. You still feel the same?
It is, man. It's just so gratifying for me personally. You know, I went through a lot of hard times this year, but... you know, I stayed strong. Everybody supported me. You know, we played well today. I'm glad for Bobby Hansen. He was the only guy that didn't have it. I'm glad for him.
Just under 5 minutes remaining in the fourth. Here is Jordan. Yes. To Frank Johnson. Rebounded by Michael Jordan. Now Frank Johnson, not the man that the Suns would have wanted to take that shot. And Jordan is able to go the distance. Oliver Miller plays it. Here's Johnson. Johnson gets, no, he could not get it off. Knocked away by Grant. It's all over. The Chicago Bulls have won three straight NBA championships.
Three-time NBA world champion Chicago Bulls. Congratulations. It's a great accomplishment.
5:20 to go in this opening quarter. Elijah Wall. Yes, that counts. Minutes left of the half. Elijah Wan. Elijah Wan now being played by Smith. Ewing has three fouls. Elijah Wan making it look very easy off the head fake. Shot clock at three. Here's Starks rejected by Elijah Wan. I don't know, Matt, to reach a point as Elijah Wan was back down court. And a 20 is taken by the Knicks. Time running out on the New York Knicks. Our Houston Rockets are the 1993-94 NBA champions.
Teamwork. Teamwork. That's the key. I just like to thank all my teammates for the great job. Kenny Smith, Maxwell, they did a wonderful job tonight.
The floor for Traxler, for Elijah. Keep it to post. Elijah Wan to the fourth. It's a 10-point lead, down to 15 seconds. Elijah Wan for three. Yes! And that will cap it off. The Houston Rockets have won their second consecutive NBA championship. They have swept the Orlando Magic.
Speaking of dreams, let's turn to Hakeem Olajuwon. Hakeem, it is obviously a team victory, a second consecutive team victory. But can you allow yourself now in the aftermath to consider where you have vaulted to among the all-time NBA greats with this postseason run?
Well, first of all, I would like to thank God for the opportunity, for giving us this opportunity to win the championship again. And I'm just so happy, especially for Clyde, to win it for the first time. And for all the teammates, thank you so much, all the fans.
Has come on for the first time. The Bulls obviously would prefer having Kukoc come off the bench. Jordan for Longley.
He just gets right to the hoop. Sean closes out on him, and then Jordan pulls the ball back, and Sam Perkins breaks down defensively.
Longley got it to Jordan. Here's Jordan. Got the step on Rakowski. Jordan! What the fuck?
Michael, I know that the first one was sweet, but how much sweeter was this one?
Well, you know, this, I can't even put it in words. My father's there, what it means to me. I know he's watching. To my wife, to my kids, to my mother, my brothers and sisters. This is for Daddy. I'm very happy for him.
Several teams have won Game 7 on the road. Well, the Chicago Bulls are hoping to wrap it up here tonight. And Michael Jordan cuts it to a five-point Utah lead.
And some sloppy pass work. Jordan, yes! He'll be looking to help out on Jordan or Pippen.
Oh, Jordan scooped it up on the steal. That's the second time he's blown the layup. And this time Jordan comes right back. Remaining in regulation, the inbound. Let's join with Ray Clay on the public address.
Congratulations, Michael Jordan, 1997 Finals MVP.
The tape didn't run off the glass.
Jordan wheels inside around Anderson. And again, it's a two-point game. It was Russell's first basket. Here's Michael. He's got 21. Michael working on Russell. Brings them to within one. 17 seconds from game seven, or from championship number six. Jordan, open. Chicago with the lead. Timeout, Utah. 5.2 seconds left. Michael Jordan running on fumes with 45 points. The Chicago Bulls have won their sixth NBA championship, and it's their second three-peat.
And tonight you gave one of the singular performances in the history of the NBA Finals. Thank you and congratulations, 1998 NBA Finals MVP, Michael Jordan.
And the corner clocks, which have been rolled onto the floor, are on. Duncan spins and hits off the glass. He's almost too good. Or does he?
Wow.
Bad mistake, Dudley. Johnson inter pass to Duncan. Comes up over Dudley for the layup. He's the only Spur to score this quarter.
To be the most valuable player of the 1999 NBA Finals, Tim Duncan.
Shaq, who is backing, and the shot goes down. So is Shaq, and he's clutching his left knee.
And Fox with one, Ori with two, and Fisher. That's 12 points in a critical game to give you a five-point lead.
Kobe Bryant off balance, and Shaquille O'Neal is there. Lakers have outscored them, though, 20-10 in this fourth quarter. Bryant Shaw, wild shot.
Here's the pass. Reggie fires, misses at the buzzer. The Lakers are champions again.
For the third time in NBA history, the same person has won the MVP of the regular season, the MVP of the All-Star game, and the MVP of the finals. This time, Shaquille O'Neal did it by averaging 38 points and 16 rebounds for the finals. To the unanimous MVP of the 2000 finals, Shaquille O'Neal.
Finally got one. Yeah.
Yeah, get a look at the dynasty. This is the next one right here.
Apparently there was audio difficulty with that report from Jim Gray. No difficulty on the part of Shaquille O'Neal.
You're going to see them add a couple three-point shooters. If they have a weakness, that's one thing that they don't do well.
O'Neal with a beautiful drop step. And here's Shaq getting down. He's able to recover that because of the bruised rib injury. Shaquille, it counts, and the foul.
17 block shots in a five-game series, 33 points a game, 16 rebounds, two consecutive MVPs. Congratulations, Shaquille O'Neal, the 2001 Finals MVP.
This time is fun, it's business. I want to thank my teammates for always looking out for me, always throwing me the ball, always, you know, helping me play well. I want to thank my parents for helping me raise well. I want to thank this guy right here for always staying on me and, you know, just helping me play hard.
Slightly off.
Robert always got to wake up.
O'Neal. Well, Shaquille.
Being bigger and better than he has to be in the series.
Here's Bryant giving it up. O'Neal. A facial. Jason Kidd getting set to return. Bryant with a beautiful setup for O'Neal. So Shaq with 14 points. On that team that went 52-30 during the regular season. Best record in the Eastern Conference. But the Lakers are on their way to a sweep. 33 points for Shaquille O'Neal.
Most valuable player of the 2002 NBA Championship Series, who averaged over 33 points a game and 12 rebounds, and who is winning his third Most Valuable Player award, none other than Shaquille O'Neal.
You know, it was tough, but, you know, my teammates, you know, they looked for me, Phil stayed on me, my father stayed on me, mother stayed on me, so I'm just happy.
Now, you told me that for you, it's all about winning championships now.
That would be correct.
Not forget that Aaron Williams' grandmother suffered a life-threatening stroke in the Detroit series, the Eastern Conference Finals. He had to miss some time.
Tim Duncan, chance for a three-point play. And speaking of quiet, that's about as much emotions you're going to see out of Tim Duncan. He knows his time is now to get his team in this ballgame. Zone defense again, and just like Kenyon Martin got a side block shot by Duncan.
They've only had two more fast break points since then.
Rodgers packs it back inside of Martin. Blocked by Duncan. That's his 31st block shot of this series. That's a new record.
Your two-time consecutive NBA MVP is the most valuable player of the 2003 NBA Finals. Congratulations, Tim Duncan.
Rebound. Now the Pistons can assume the lead here. Phillips puts it on his hip, goes all the way. That's the bounce. And he'll inbound with 19 seconds on the clock. Underneath, Phillips reverse, puts it in. So Chauncey Phillips. Kobe loses the ball. There's no foul in the lane. Here's Phillips on a drive. Got it. Goes to the line.
You saw it. 21 points a game, over five assists. The 2004 NBA Finals MVP, number one, Chauncey Phillips.
This team was able to overcome the Lakers.
Because we just believe in ourselves and we play team basketball. We're not just individuals. We got individual good players, but we're a great basketball team and we know that that can overcome every time.
Congratulations, MVP of the finals, Chauncey Phillips.
Duncan comes way outside with Wallace on him and then puts it up off the glass.
Get the ball to Duncan early and let him operate in the clock. Mainly because both teams count on them. They're either the number one or number two scorer for their team.
near turnover, but Duncan saves it and scores. Here's Duncan inside. Gets it back, puts it in, and gets fouled.
When San Antonio won this game, not there, right here. This is where Duncan was a monster in that second half in the overtime. 8 offensive rebounds. Now you have your switch here now. So you have Prince on Timmy Duncan.
And you also have 2 on the shot clock. And from the corner, it's Duncan. And the San Antonio Spurs, with tough defense, and Tim Duncan answering a lot of questions.
The MVP of the NBA Finals, Tim Duncan.
Seven to 9-0.
Terry is the leading scorer for the Mavericks in these finals. His Wade hits it, and a foul. Avery Johnson upset with Wade with a chance for a 3-point play. Wade with the jumper. Wade has Terry on him now. Dwayne Wade knocks it down. The Heat have gone about 4.5 minutes without a point.
Did we have another run?
Well, that run just ended right there. As Wade knocks down another, he's got 15. Wade right at Daniels. Tough shot, count it, and a foul.
Oh, my. Yeah, that's, first of all, Daniels played them too soft all the way down. Now, if you keep backing up, he'll keep moving forward. And then you just do not do a ticky-tack foul. If you're going to foul him hard, get his arm so that he doesn't get up on the shot.
Wade gets inside, finding O'Neal, and Shaquille O'Neal banks it in. Terry puts it up, won't go, rebound Wade. The Miami Heat, they've done it. They win their first championship in franchise history.
He was very much the heart of an extraordinary team, and I do mean team. Congratulations, 2006 MVP, Dwayne Wade.
Parker inside, nice move. Gibson for 3. And Parker the rebound. Here's Parker. So quick down the... Oh, what a shot from Parker! Lightning fast, and then a circus shot as he falls down. And here comes Parker. Oh, Parker, another pretty move and finish.
LeBron, top of the key. Fans out right side, a deep fall-away jump shot, rimming off badly. Rebound taken by Parker. Sprints to midcourt, gets by Pavlovich into the lane. Lays it up and in! Tony Parker again! This time going 1-on-3, taking Pavlovich into the paint, abusing him with a scoop shot and the foul. Tony Parker.
With almost 25 points a game, a shooting percentage of 57% for the finals. A performance that, how shall we say it, was extraordinaire. So to the MVP of the 2007 NBA Finals, Tony Parker, we say congratulations and bon chance.
They were better in game 5 as Pierce pulls up with off balance, but that's his first field goal.
Doc Rivers didn't like it.
Pierce, a long 3, rattles it in. Still over 21 minutes left in this one. We're early in the 3rd. Pierce left-handed. Pretty play for Pierce.
It is the truth. The MVP of the 2008 NBA Finals is Paul Pierce.
Pretty long journey for a guy who almost a year ago was asking to be traded. Didn't think he'd be a part of this franchise. He gets the MVP trophy. He stands up on that small platform up higher, pumps his right fist, puts the trophy in it, holds it high overhead.
And now we bring home champion 17.
Here comes Kobe Bryant, who in the last two games has really charged out of the gates. He had 17 in the first quarter of game three, 13 in the first quarter of game four, and that's his first field goal tonight. Trying to send this finals back to Los Angeles. Kobe Bryant and the finish.
I really don't think people appreciate how great this guy is. I learned early on as a broadcaster, you don't want to throw around the word great. Well, I'm going to go out on a limb and say this guy is great. As good as we've seen at the two guard position. Well, absolutely. There was a time where this guy would try to get 50 tonight and his team would have a chance of winning. But they're at their best when he's making plays.
Wow, and speak of making plays, Bryant banks it in, off balance, falling down. Shot clock down to 8. Bryant fires a 3, puts it in. Kobe Bryant from downtown. And the lead back to 16.
The MVP of the 2009 NBA Finals, who averaged 32 points plus, who averaged almost 6 rebounds and 7 assists a game, Kobe Bryant.
It's all inside to Kobe Bryant.
Absolutely. It's the first quarter lead. As Bryant takes, you know, where are the Celtics going to find offense right now?
Bryant on the pull-up. Puts it in. 4-point Laker lead. Their largest of the game. Timeout Boston. Rebound to Saul. Kicks it out to Odom. Odom throws it ahead. Repeat back-to-back titles. The LA Lakers, the 2010 NBA champions.
The 2010 Finals MVP and the winner of the Bill Russell NBA Finals MVP is none other than Kobe Bryant.
From one great champion to another, Kobe Bryant, your fifth NBA championship. How does this one stand out for you more than 1, 2, 3, and 4?
Well, this is the sweetest.
Anthony on Nowitzki. Nowitzki trying to find some space, top shot.
And to me, I think that's the way they should play.
Nowitzki puts it up, puts it in. Dirk Nowitzki makes it a 10-point game. Timeout Miami with 2:27 remaining. The Dallas Maverick fans starting to celebrate. Nowitzki, left hand, lays it in. And it's 103-92. And that should do it for the Dallas Mavericks. The emotions of Dirk Nowitzki, what he's always dreamed of, hoping to have another chance after the bitter loss in 2006.
And the MVP of this series with an average of 26 points and almost 10 rebounds a game, Dirk Nowitzki.
Hart back on James, quick spin, drive right at Perkins and banks it in.
Harden's body, and that's too easy, and Perkins has no chance to get outside and really have a chance to impact that shot. But the strength, did you see the contortion of the body?
Looking to clinch their franchise's second championship. Wade throws it to James down the lane, layup, banks it in. Largest lead of the night. Timeout Thunder. Wade flips it up, that won't go. Still battling for rebounds, James won't. Gets another one, puts it up, banks it in, and a foul. He gets his triple-double and a chance for a three-point play. LeBron James captures that elusive title he so desperately coveted. What a difference a year makes.
It's the unanimous choice for the MVP, the Bill Russell Most Valuable Player Trophy of the 2012 NBA Finals.
And the Bullets won in 78. Nice pass. And James converts it.
There are some guys like Dwayne Wade who looks energetic.
James, and a foul. Took a hard hit, put it in, and a chance for a three-point play. Six to shoot, James. It's good. James pulls up, puts it in. Four-point lead. 35 for LeBron James. Timeout San Antonio. The 2013 NBA Championship resides once again in Miami.
The 2013 Bill Russell NBA Finals Most Valuable Player is, for the second straight finals, LeBron James.
Good defense to force Parker. The other way, Leonard will try a three. Their first field goal. Leonard for three. Bang! First lead of the game for the Spurs.
A stop and it turns into two stops. Then you can establish a rhythm.
Leonard shields the ball with his body and lays it in.
The Spurs are the 2014 NBA champions.
Kawhi Leonard. The fans of San Antonio know how great you are, and now the whole world does. You are the 2014 Bill Russell MVP.
If I had told you when the NBA Finals began that you would be the most valuable player of this series, you would have said what?
Man, I would have told you you was lying or something. But right now, it's just surreal to me.
James spins, pivots, stripped and stolen by Iguodala. Here's Curry. Andre Iguodala with another fine defensive play. Iguodala left open, takes the dribble and knocks down the shot. Curry finds Iguodala. Makes another two-point attempt. He almost picked up his fifth as he turned it over. Iguodala fakes, drives and finishes. Approaching the midway point here of the fourth. Green drives. Green kicks it out. Iguodala, wide open shot. Hits a three-pointer. That's the 10th assist for Draymond Green.
Rebound by the Warriors, Steph Curry. And it's over. The championship is back in the Bay for the first time in 40 years. The Golden State Warriors, the 2015 NBA champions.
It could have been a lot of these guys, but there can only be one MVP. And this year's MVP is a player who didn't start in a single game until these finals. This year's Bill Russell MVP, Andre Iguodala.
Curry helps out. Smith, pass right through the hands of Curry. James, the two-handed slam. Curry had that steal, but it slipped through his hands, and LeBron James takes advantage. James drives in hard. Nice adjustment with the left hand. Shot clock down to seven. Irving sets for three. Short rebound knocked out of Shumpert's hands. Iguodala. Curry drives again. Left-handed blocked by James. Rejected out of bounds. He's done that a couple of times in these finals, and the two of them have some words. Five to shoot. Azealia again goes back up on him. James steps back for three. Puts it in. LeBron James from downtown. Irving drives, hop step inside, floats it up, misses. Rebound taken by Iguodala. Iguodala to Curry, back to Iguodala, up for the layup. Oh, blocked by James.
Oh my goodness. Great pass by Curry, running hard by Iguodala. And superhuman defensive recovery by LeBron James.
By Spates, final seconds. It's over. It's over. Cleveland is a city of champions once again. The Cavaliers are NBA champions.
I set out a goal 2 years when I came back to bring a championship to this city. I gave everything that I had. I put my heart, my blood, my sweat, my tears to this game, and against all odds, I don't know why we want to take the hardest road. I don't know why the man above gives me the hardest road, but it's nothing the man above don't put you in situations that you can't handle. And I just kept that same positive attitude, like, instead of saying, why me, they're saying, this is what he want me to do. And Cleveland, this is for you.
Tristan Thompson was fouled before he went into the active shooter. Durant from way outside, drills a three-pointer. Just under 3.5 to play in the third. Durant has an opening, and nails the three. Big shot after big shot from both teams. Half, they've trailed this game by as many as 17. Durant, jump shot, got it. Curry, Iguodala, Thompson, Durant, and Green. Inside, Durant. Durant gets away from Porter, all the way to the rim. Timeout, Cleveland.
He's been a perennial all-star. He's been the league MVP, but he's never been the finals MVP. You're Bill Russell, 2017 finals MVP, Kevin Durant.
Durant has George Hill, mismatch there. James looking to help, Durant spins the other way and gets his first bucket. How sensational was he in game three?
He was absolutely unbelievable.
Durant cuts inside, gorgeous pass there from Draymond Green. His team down by 11, 5 to shoot. J.R. Smith on Durant. Durant finds some space, jump shot is up, soft touch bounces in.
There are guys that catch the basketball in that position, and the pressure of the defense bothers them.
And this will be their sixth straight win to close out the season and get themselves another championship. Durant backs it home. 20 points for Durant.
And got fouled like 4 times.
Final seconds here of this 2018 NBA season. There's the buzzer. There's a new dynasty in the NBA. The Golden State Warriors champions once again, back-to-back titles, 3 in 4 years, and the latest with a sweep.
And this year, the back-to-back NBA Finals MVP, Kevin Durant.
And Golden State win another title without Kevin Durant here in the finals. Leonard gets inside, goes reverse, backs it home.
Looney's struggling to finish around the rim. Cousins just finishing well.
Leonard finishes and gets hit. And a chance for a three-point play. As Kawhi Leonard starting to come alive scoring-wise.
That's grown man strength by Kawhi Leonard.
Serge Ibaka. Inside pass, Leonard. Leonard counted out a foul. Once again, that strength, he got hit. And still able to finish. Now the Warriors just inbound, and that's it. There's a new NBA champion, and it's a team from Toronto, Canada. We the North are now we the champions, the Raptors, the 2019 NBA champs.
And our MVP, following an iconic buzzer beater and a dominant performance in the finals, your 2019 Bill Russell Finals MVP is Kawhi Leonard.
Involved in as many plays as possible, LeBron James.
Good defense there from Davis. Forces a turnover, and James with the flush down the other end. Bam Adebayo floats it up. That comes up short.
They have missed some very makeable point-blank shots as James continues to attack in transition. And over again, when they have numbers in transition, they convert. Well, first of all, I don't think he's healthy and whole, but I think it's a harder decision than what you say as James attacks the rim without any help and one.
James goes to the rim once again, lays it up and in, and he's in double figures.
I have a feeling that this finals MVP is going to have a trophy named after him one day. The finals MVP is LeBron James.
It's too much hand holding on to the ball.
The spin move, the finish. Giannis does it again. The lead is up to 11. Giannis tries a three. It's good. Giannis Antetokounmpo. Antetokounmpo calling for it. Goes against Crowder, gets inside. Banker won't go. The rebound back up and in. Brute strength from Giannis. And the Bucks go up by three. Timeout Phoenix. Middleton inside. Nice entry pass. And the slam from Antetokounmpo. Holiday looking. Inside Antetokounmpo. Puts up the one-hander. Shot is good. Does it again. But that's what I call star power. And a huge smile.
This year's Bill Russell Finals MVP, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
On the 24, Williams looking for help. Curry takes him off the dribble, gets inside, layup is good. Oh, what a beautiful move from Curry.
How about Steph Curry? Gets White in the air, a flyby, makes him pay the price. We're witnessing greatness.
Rebound Wiggins. Four rebounds so far. Curry sidestep, wide open three, got it. Curry sidestep, three-pointer. It's good. Steph Curry from downtown. And a lead back up to 19. Six assists for Green. Curry along three. It's good. Steph Curry from way downtown. Some Curry chaos here on the third. With 1:30 remaining.
Steph Curry gets open, wide open. The side out of bounds. Al Horford fly by. Sigh of relief in the building, realizing that Steph Curry with the shot has just put you to sleep.
First Steph Curry with his dad. The emotion's just pouring out. It might be his fourth, but it means so much. All the sacrifice, all the work. Boy, these Warriors are ready to celebrate.
And for the first time ever, he's an NBA Finals MVP. The 2022 Bill Russell NBA Finals MVP Award goes to Stephen Curry.
I mean, I hear all the conversations, I hear all the chatter, we hear all the chatter. At the end of the day, it's about what we do on the floor. Ain't gotta talk about it, just gotta go do it, and that's what this is about.
Christian Brown in the game, the rookie for the Nuggets. Jokic, nice feed, and Green banks it home.
That's why you can't let him see two people and create an opening, because he's going to make you pay every single time.
Murray and Jokic play catch. Vincent on him, out of bio, lurking. Ball poked away, Jokic gets it back, puts it up and in, and a foul. Bruce Brown, back to Jokic. Spins against Adebayo, tough shot, pulling away, still knocks it down.
So effective attacking the middle of that zone area.
Finds Jokic. Martin on him. Jokic drives down a lane. Layup is good. Nuggets back up by one. The Heat will let it play out. It's over. At last, the long wait is over. After 47 years, the Denver Nuggets can finally call themselves NBA champions.
This year's Bill Russell Finals MVP goes to Nikola Jokic.
Being on display here, the lack of it.
Jaylen Brown comes flying in on the pass from Holiday. Falls down, ball knocked loose. Look at the White dive on it, saved by Horford. Here comes Brown. Brown goes up, layup is good.
and the lead is back to 15.
Tatum goes inside, flips it out, Brown, three-pointer, puts it in. Jaylen Brown with 14, another assist for Tatum, he's got 9. Jaylen Brown gets in the paint, finds Holiday, the left hand off the glass. Timeout Dallas, it's a 26-point lead. This crowd on its feet, the best team in basketball all year. All the work, all the sacrifice, handling the enormous weight of massive expectations. Ends tonight here. It's over. Time to say it again, Boston. Anything's possible. Banner number 18 has been secured. The Celtics are NBA champions.
The 2024 Bill Russell Finals MVP goes to Jaylen Brown.
It was a full team effort, and I shared this with my brothers and my partner in crime, Jason Tatum. He was with me the whole way, so we shared it together.